Nick Schiffer, and this is Site Visit, and we're back here over at 45 White Oak here in Wellesley. This is our spec home that we're building, and last time we were here, we had just started framing, and today we're just about complete with framing. The guys are doing all of the detail framing, all of the punch out carpentry, essentially getting this place ready to turn it over to the trades. So I want to take a few minutes to walk through the project. And as I stand here in the front, you'll see that the entire structure is up. The massing of this home is now unveiled. And a couple things that you're going to notice is that there's no overhangs on the home. And you also see this little parapet wall up at the roof line. All of this gets wrapped with two layers of exterior insulation, rock wool comfort board, from the foundation up the side of the wall and all the way up to the roof line. So that parapet actually gets buried in insulation. And then its final detail will be that Peterson cover brick that clads up the wall to an integrated gutter on the roof line and then up all the way to what is, you know, that ridge of the home. There's a lot to walk through here. There's a lot of detailing. I wanna call attention to the fact that we worked with Cape Cod panel on this home. And there's a lot of benefits to building this off-site. And while we were doing site work, these walls were being fabricated, taking advantage of doing it off-site. We were able to think about the entire structure before we got on site, actually building the home. One of the testaments to that is my steel guy called and said, hey, I wanna verify, Ryan from RMS Ironworks, I wanna verify that the HSS rafters that I'm welding plates to, that the plates are in the right spot. So I called the framer and I said, hey, can I get a verification on that wall dimension on that second floor? And they called me back and it was exactly as per plan, right where it needed to be. We were able to fabricate those rafters, get them on site. And a few of you guys actually reached out and said, hey, was this 100% accurate? Were there no mistakes? Of course not. Nothing's ever gonna be perfect, but I would say that this is as close as you're gonna get. Very few misses, very few mistakes. Maybe I'll point them out in this video. But let's start here in the living room. So the living room, you see kind of a bunch of different framing members. I wanna point out is that all of these floor joists actually get detailed architecturally with a oak beam wrap. And that oak beam wrap is very specifically spaced across. So despite these being different dimensions, they're perfectly spaced apart. So when those oak beams go up, they wrap the bottom of those beams, creating a nice consistent span all the way across. Huge shout out to Madera. So Madera is our partner on this project for all of the white oak product. We actually went into a design meeting with them and we had this living room detailed out and there was this center beam here. And the question came up as to why we had a center beam. And we said, well, from this location to that location is about 27 feet. And we knew we didn't think we'd be able to get these in a single piece, which Madera was actually able to step up and get all of these beams in a single piece of oak. There will be no seams and no center beam, which is gonna be really a dramatic look. Talking about specifically what we see on site, all the strapping up here, the guys actually took strapping, did the full ceiling layout, and made sure that as they were putting these members in place, that they landed where they needed to. I know you guys are gonna ask, what's up with the different framing? Why do you have two by and I-joist? All of our drop sections, anywhere we have stone or tile in this house, we've actually dropped the subfloor more than just our traditional 3/4 inch. When we're installing the hardwood floor and then when we come back to install our tile, those are all varying thicknesses. We actually have the ability to build that floor up and hit dead flush with our wood floor. So in this section here is actually where our primary vanity is. There's some blue marble on the floor. And this actually right here is our blue marble primary shower, as well as our tub. And we've even made provisions for all of our drains coming through the floor. Part of that thinking through process when we're building it off site. I'm gonna come back to this area. Over in the kitchen, very similar ceiling detail. All of these beams get wrapped. Again, you're gonna see a bunch of different framing members. You have I-joists, you have LVL, and you can see how all of the framing has been modified to allow that to sit where it needed to be to support the structure above. It's all dropped and it's all prepped for stone and tile. This is one of the, this is actually the Jack and Jill bathroom for bedroom number 3 and number 4. Question might come up is, well, why use traditional lumber there and I-joist everywhere else? Well, it just was a matter of what was required. This is a breakfast area and outdoor kitchen. I think last episode we actually ended here in our outdoor kitchen space. And what this, you know, actually originally was going to be living space, below. And we opted not to because we're on solid ledge. We anchored both of these outside posts down. We have these amazing shear panels that actually hold the back of this home and create the shear strength that we need. But this outdoor space is really nice because this entire back wall opens up. You have this outdoor space, really, really nice decking. One of the details, I could probably leave this to the viewer's discretion to see if they notice it, but our flooring is gonna run from, you know, front to back in the home, and we want our decking to do the same. And the way that this is framed, you wouldn't be able to do that now. So there's actually a detail that allows us to orient the decking to be in line with the interior floorboards. Speaking of the floorboards, all of these floorboards here will be 12 to 18 inch wide, European white oak, 6 to 16 feet in length. Really beautiful product applied to us by Madera. They're also going to be working with us on all of the millwork and a bunch of the other components. Back in the entryway, actually, I'll pull you into the actual entryway. When I stand here, this is gonna be our front door. This will be a cedar door, full height, floor to ceiling. Cedar door will swing in. This right here is actually about 2.5 inches lower than all of our other subfloor. And the reason being is that out here, we have a brick, which will match the brick that is on our front stairs, will match the brick that's on our retaining walls, as well as the planter that will be on this future bridge. But that brick is a full depth brick, and we want to be using the same exact brick on the inside of the home, creating this really flush transition. So this right here, you know, about 2.5 inches higher, we'll have our brick, and this right here, we'll get a roof, insulation, and then a pedestal system for, or not a pedestal system, but a system, a geomat system to essentially put our brick on here and have this flush transition between inside and out, and then go from a flush transition to a full depth brick to our wood floor on the inside of the home. This here is a giant window, which passes all the way through the backyard, and then a huge skylight above. So the skylight ends up about 9 foot by 9 foot, and I've talked about it a lot, but it's one of my favorite features in this home. And one of the parts I love about it the most is the fact that there is nothing in that skylight besides sky. There's no tree line, there's no neighbors, there's nothing. It's only blue sky, and it lights up what is the future dining space, but doesn't do it in a way that is overly bearing or a ton of light pouring down. As we work our way up the stairs, these are temporary stairs. We're working with a stair manufacturer off-site. We'll share the details on that in the future. Really beautiful staircase, really complicated inside curves with a white oak railing that is full height with a plaster wall. Again, really tight radiuses, actually a really complicated stair. Been going back and forth with the stair builder on how we're gonna accomplish that, but it will be a really fun part to actually execute. So looking at the second floor here on this kind of walkway platform that looks down on, you know, the dining room and entry. And then if you look up where the skylight is, we have these sloping ceilings that bring you all the way up to the skylight. Each of those sections, the steep one, these two are less steep. And then you have a vertical portion here. All of those will be actually clad in the Peterson cover brick. Very same material that's on the outside. It's actually a difficult detail to accomplish because you're essentially fighting gravity as those go up the backward slope. We're working through how we're gonna do that attachment. We have a couple ideas, but of course, if you guys watching the video have any ideas, happy to hear that. You're gonna see a lot of these double walls, and the reason why these double walls are here, we're gonna save for a future video when Vincent's here. There's a handful of reasons, but the number one and the most common is the fact that we get a fully insulated wall, because remember, we have actually 5 inches of exterior insulation, full cavity insulation, and then all of our mechanicals will live inside this service cavity wall, allowing us to have uninterrupted insulation. We're in the primary here. This is where you saw the subfloor dropped. So this is our future shower and wet room. It's all blue marble, working with the guys at Emser Tile and Stone. They're gonna be helping us with that, including the tub. And then here we have essentially blue marble that is recessed into the floor. And then spanning between the two, you actually have hardwood. Really fun and difficult detail to accomplish, but essentially we have this seamless transition from wood into your shower with stone. So waterproofing details are gonna be absolutely critical. And then we're gonna be working with Schluter product throughout all of the bathrooms, including the shower, to make sure that our waterproofing detail is exactly the way we need. And then if you pass through here, we have our toilet room, And then we have this beautiful closet. One thing actually that came up, the guys have been working up on the roof and the skylight. I realized it's gonna be really difficult to get up on that roof. So we're gonna be cutting an access hatch in here. We're gonna be looking for basically a super insulated one. Quite literally 5 minutes ago, I was talking to Vincent about this, about making sure that we hit our insulation requirement. And we're gonna be using a pretty traditional roof hatch. And then what he called is essentially an insulation plug. So when it's closed, we essentially install a plug underneath that hatch to make sure that we have that R60 that we're trying to accomplish on that rooftop, making sure we're hitting or exceeding our energy requirements. In the primary bedroom here, this is one of the rooms that I walked in and realized, wow, this room's a lot bigger than I thought, than the plan. But what I appreciate the most is that I'm in the bed location. And when I look in this direction, it's nothing but trees. When I look in this direction, I have trees that block the majority of the home back there. And when I look out here, I do get some view of that home, but this is quite literally one of the only areas that you see. This is the most that you're gonna see of homes out the window, because in this direction here, it's all greenery. And that's something I really appreciate about the design and the consideration for windows and doors. You do still have this sense of privacy. One of the things that we dealt with here is actually these ceilings. So you'll see that we have all of these false ceilings, and basically the flat ceiling has been pushed up about 4 feet. Originally, all of these were flat ceilings on the second floor, and here in Wellesley, you deal with this thing called T-lag, and it's essentially the total living area gross, and our attic space was actually too tall. Even though there were structural components and you could never use the space as living space, by that code, they were counting that as additional square footage. But the way to counteract that was actually to push the ceilings up. So similar to the floor that we're gonna have here, that really beautiful wide European white oak, we're gonna have the same European white oak going up the slope ceiling as well as the flat ceiling. So really tying all of this together, playing off that whole white oak. As we work our way down, I'm actually gonna go back through the primary because we walked in that hallway first. But we actually have this hallway as well. And this hallway goes down. Again, you come out to what is the entryway, that double height space with the skylight. And then you have another bedroom here. And this is what we would consider a junior primary. And the reason that it's connected off the primary like that, you could be using this for a guest or family member. But essentially it also could be set up as a home office if you wanted that. So this is a junior primary, has its own bathroom here, as well as a shower. Really cool. I'm gonna save this for a later date, but the vanity essentially sits in front of the window, and there's always this, you know, consideration for, well, what do I do with my mirrors? People hang them in front of their windows. We have a really cool detail that we'll share in the future. As you work your way back out, you come down into that hallway, and then you get into bedroom number three with the Jack and Jill bathroom. Again, this subfloor is dropped down. The entire bathroom is about 2 inches lower, giving us that ability to really dial in the floor height for the tile thickness and be completely flush with the wood floor on either side. Bedroom number four, everyone has their own closet. We have the laundry room tucked in between the two in the hallway there. And then lastly, we have bedroom number five. And this bedroom here has, again, its own bathroom. Beautiful window here, kind of tucked in the corner of this bathroom space, and then a really big window that overlooks the other side of the home. I do wanna hop all the way down because there's two other things that I think are really important to talk about. So why don't we go downstairs? So one of the things that is really important on this project is these big windows and doors. This opening here is about 20 feet long. These 2x6s are temporary. They will come out and a single unit will go in here. Talked about it in the past, but this plywood is all actually a void because our door system actually sits down into our floor system. So actually when this door is installed, it's a lift slide door. So it essentially drops into position to be sealed. And then when you're operating it, the door lifts up by a handle rotation. But when the door is in its resting position, there's actually only 1/8 of an inch from the bottom of the door to our hardwood floor. So really tight tolerances, really specific on heights when it comes to how this is detailed. But what happens with these large doors is that you run into issues with shear. And the shear is oftentimes counteracted with steel structure. And originally, or not originally, but in discussion was this potential for a steel column, steel beam, and steel column. We're actually able to remove that by using these Simpson Strong walls. It is a shear panel. What happens here is you have these giant anchors, and these anchors are drilled down into the foundation 20 inches. Some of you guys asked, why not cast them in place? We could have. And actually the drawings actually showed it being cast in place originally, but we didn't, and we drilled them after. And then this panel with steel and obviously this engineered wood product is all screwed together and essentially anchors to the foundation, goes up and captures the LVL at the very top. And if you guys remember, that LVL top is a quad LVL with two pieces of steel in it. You see all the bolts going across it, called a flitch beam. And now that creates our shear, you know, strength on this back wall. So we have one here. We also have one here, and this is helping with the kitchen door. This is also a large lift and slide door, but we have the corner there that's tied down the foundation. We have a panel here, and then again, we talked about this a few moments ago, but then we have the two on the back here that essentially capture bedroom number 5 that sits over our outdoor living space. The outdoor living space, we have outdoor kitchen here, and then we have an outdoor living space over there, which we actually didn't need from a shear perspective. We were able to accomplish that with the way it was framed. But these two spaces are gonna be, you know, really valuable in the way this home is lived in, and also really helps anchor the home, especially on that first floor. So excited to see how these develop over time. Where we're at today, we're wrapping up framing. We have our underground plumbing in the basement. We're actually prepping for concrete down there. Concrete's also working on the front steps. So the guys from Mass Concrete are working on the architectural steps. And then just shortly, in just a short few weeks, we're gonna be rolling right into mechanicals. So we're going to be going into HVAC, plumbing, as well as electrical, which will be obviously really important parts of the project. And we're going to talk through some of the important things that we pay attention to, not only from the way it's executed, but the products that we use. Stay tuned for the next episode. We'll see you then.